Meet Vive, My HTC Vive. And an HTC Vive is a system that uses lighthouses, like that one there, and that one up there, to do something called room scale tracking, so that you can jump around or do whatever you want inside of a very large area, and it's still able to track. It's not like a very limited area like it is with Oculus or the PSVR. So about a year ago, me thinking that, you know, lighthouse tracking is the coolest thing ever, me and a bunch of people started to go hack it. First, hacking the Watchman, and then the rest of the system, trying to put together kind of our own SteamVR clone, I guess you'd say. And so the HTC Vive was just amazing. But there is one problem. It's got all these cables that you have to have wired up to the headset, so you're still tethered. Now, there are wireless systems out there, but they eat up huge amounts of the spectrum and have other latency issues and all of that associated with them. So, this year, for April 1st, I decided to go make my own system. And instead of it being wireless, one where I would need a PC to stream, I decided I would do all of the rendering on the Vive itself. So, that's what I have going here. If you want to see the live stream, it's available in the description. So right now I'm using that inside there. It's an orange Pi to do the rendering. I have two extra power supplies right there and there, which provide power from this really nice big lithium polymer battery, and it hooks up to the Vive headset. So right now, without being attached with any wires, I can just wear this and walk around. Right now I just have a little demonstration right there, kind of like in the middle of my, it's kind of near where the chair is, and I can walk around. You can kind of see it, like viewing it from another point of view here. And all of this is totally self-contained. The Vive software is running on the Orange Pi, a little $19 computer. And because it's a wireless system, you can even stream the video to a web browser so that your friends can see exactly what you're seeing. So all of this is possible without any tether, taking up a huge portion of the radio spectrum, or anything else ridiculous. Just look at this. It's so simple, so easy to use. Why wouldn't people use the Orange Pi to play the Vive?